Hi witches, so yeah, today I am sitting on the floor. I am in the middle of working on my collection, so there's just stuff all over my studio right now, and my chair is like holding a bunch of stuff, so we're sitting on the floor. But today I wanted to kind of reflect on the new moon ritual that I did yesterday, and I think it's good to, after any sort of big ritual working, definitely take notes like right after, but also try to reflect a little bit the day after. Sorry, I'm picking up a pin so I don't step on it later. So I had a really great time last night. I had a very powerful experience, and I wanted to talk about that a little bit with you guys today, if you don't mind indulging me. But yeah, basically I went through, I did all my candle spells, I had my incense going, and then I was going to go blow out my candles because like I thought, I know a lot of witches are like, you should always snuff everything out. I did not grow up with that practice. I've read it everywhere now, but like, it's just not something that I don't really see a difference. You're still extinguishing a flame. Like, I don't know. I understand the principle. I get it. It's just not part of my practice. Anyways, I was working with my deities and I, was ready to end the working, I thought, and I went to go blow everything out, and the candles would not go out. Like, it was really crazy. I was like, I don't think I have emphysema all of a sudden. This is really strange. Yeah, so I kind of like knelt down at my altar and like was eye level with my deity candles, and the Morrigan told me to meditate, so I did. I didn't really know what to do. I literally like picked the first meditation I could find. I typed in like transformation meditation on YouTube because I was not expecting to be doing this. And, it was fantastic. I'm gonna link it down below. It was really profound for me, and really powerful. But basically, like within that meditation space, I felt my gods kind of surrounding me and like holding me, which was really nice. And also I had this like crazy, I don't wanna say vision, cause like I feel like that sounds like really woo woo, but I don't know how else to explain it. But basically it was like this image, I guess, of myself as like a slightly older version of myself, if that makes any sense. Like, I don't know, maybe like 30, which is like a big age for me that I'm like terrified of. And I like saw myself taking like a very young version of myself by the hand, and excuse me while I get emotional. We're back. Sorry. It's a lot. It's still really fresh. So this is like the power of witchcraft making me cry. Basically all of the versions of myself walked through this door, and it was like really nice. I guess I can't get to a point where I'm not crying about it in this video, so I'm gonna do my best. But that was basically the gist of the meditation. So like the message I got from that, the way I like interpreted that, was like very much like, you are in this space now. Take some time, you're almost there, basically. Like, just keep going. I know I'm like super emotional right now, but my period's coming, so that's probably it. But it was a really raw and like real experience for me. It was a really beautiful moment, and I'm really glad it happened, because like for a while there I really felt like I was like faltering in my craft and like in my practice. I don't know, I just felt like a lot of it, I was like, why is none of this working? But I think we got through a big block yesterday. I hope everyone else's new moon rituals were great. I hope they don't like reduce you to tears like me. I'm just a huge crybaby. Like, that's something that people don't like actually know about me. I cry all the time, like it's a mess. So yeah, I hope everyone enjoyed their new moon, and I will see you tomorrow with some more moon information and a lot less crying, I promise. Bye guys.